UFC flyweight division title. So here he is, the number one flyweight contender, looking to change that title here in 25 minutes or fewer and leave as the undisputed UFC flyweight champion of the world. What a run to contention it has been for this young man. He has put together a long winning streak. He's got the finishes to make the fans happy. He's done everything to position himself for this type of championship opportunity. Now, under the lights, we'll see what he can do with it. So here he is, the UFC's reigning, defending, undisputed UFC flyweight champion, making the walk for another defense here tonight. And if he wants to be mentioned with some of this division's greats of all time, and really with some of the greats of all time, this is one he's got to have here tonight. As the title defenses start to pile up, you can be mentioned in the conversation with guys like Demetrius Johnson. So here we go, another title defense here at 125. We'll see how it goes for the reigning champ. All right, let's get you the tail of the tape for this flyweight championship fight. More than 5 years apart, with similar height and reach. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Eve Loving. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas, it's time! Our rounds for the undisputed UFC flyweight championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a jiu-jitsu fighter holding a professional record of 18 wins, 5 losses, and 2 draws. He stands 5 feet 7 inches tall, weighing in at 125 pounds. Presenting the challenger, Brandon the Assassin Baby. And now, introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 20 wins, 1 loss, and 1 draw. He stands 5 feet 5 inches tall, weighing in at 125 pounds. Fighting at Asuara Para, Brazil, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC flyweight champion of the world, Son Donaguerra Figueiredo!
UFC belt on the line, guys. Protect yourself at all time. Obey my command at all time. If you want to touch love, do it now. Go back to your corner.
Despite his opponent's submission acumen, he's more than willing to engage him.
A lot of times guys fight with their ego. They try to go and fight their opponent in their spots. Let's see if this proves to be a very bad decision.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the...
Oh!
Wow!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish this fight.
Oh, straight right.
Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks. Leg kick after leg kick after leg kick.
And he connects there. Good series of strikes by him.
Great job of mixing it up, staying active, keeping busy, doing great work.
Both guys throwing potential fight enders here in the early going. Now he counters with a right hook to the head. All right, so 1 minute into the fight, we've got a full-on...
Oh, that was a big takedown. Is this the one that's going to break him?
Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom. Not the arm, it's the shoulder pressure that usually makes you tap.
But now DC trying to isolate an arm.
Yep, he used the kimura.
Bottom fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head or he's going to get blasted.
Well, hard to win fights in mixed martial arts from the bottom, but nice work here in that position by Brandon Moreno. Now he touches him with the left. All right, under 3 minutes now to go in round one. All right, so he's sort of turtled up here. Not great body language. Perhaps he's trying to bait him in a little bit. All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. Oh, how about the speed on that reversal there? I mean, I know you can get out of some bad spots, but not with that type of speed.
You cannot allow him to get leverage on the bottom. What a sweep.
Well, pretty good work off of the bottom here by Brandon Moreno. All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. Oh, big combination of ground and pound strikes here, DC. This could be the beginning of the end.
I mean, you got to be very careful when you take these big ground and pound strikes. You need a controlled posture on the bottom. And if you're the top guy, the guy that's looking to finish, continue to gain posture and rain down big strikes on your opponent. Oh, wow, oh!
And he's out. Oh, and he's able to land a strike there from the bottom. Nicely done by the assassin baby, Brandon Moran. Good, solid strike on the ground. Oh, nice job to reverse position on the ground.
It was bad, but now it's not so bad. What a fantastic sweep.
All right, working inside the closed guard now. Well, he continues to manhandle him here on the ground. So 37 total strikes have now landed for Davison Figueroa. And now he goes with the combination of punches to the head, potentially some concussive damage there.
I mean, absolutely concussive damage. Landing all those strikes to the head, he's very active, he's very fast, and he has a real confidence every time he throws his punches.
All right, he engages in a single collar tie here. Oh, combination of knees. That is not what he is looking for. He better raise that guard quickly.
He better raise that guard or he's going to fall asleep. You cannot allow someone to knee you in the head.
Oh, he lands a massive kick here.
Oh, nice right hand. Oh, he did a great job of rotating him into an underhook.
Oh, collar tie. Oh, slips to avoid the right. So he's really starting to put together some significant body shots here. These are going to take their toll as this fight goes on.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he going to follow this one?
But now DC trying to isolate an arm.
Yep, he's using the kimura.
Take a deep breath and relax. You lost that last round. This round, we need to go out there and force our jiu-jitsu game on this guy. You can't hang with your arm.
All right, so perhaps a little frustration creeping in as our next round gets underway. Very close to submitting his opponent in the previous round, but was unable to do so.
Wasn't able to do it, but he was so, so very close. He just tried to put himself back in that position, and maybe this time he gets the finish he wants so bad. Yes, they heard him in the last round. Same exact one. Good punch.
And he's looking for that left hand, just missed. Well, that nose isn't gonna be able to take too many more as he doubles up on the jab there.
So good to watch MMA evolve and watch guys now fight behind the jab.
There's the leg kick, that one checked by Brandon Malik. Left hook to the head.
Look at how he turns his hip over when he throws that kick.
Back and forth we go. How about that shin? All right, he closes the distance, gets the single collar tie.
What a punch. Oh! Look at the finish now, because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh, beautiful jab by him there. Got that to the target quickly.
He's dictating the fight with a jab.
And now he lands a combination. Oh, nice jab by him there. And I guess on the other side, hard to get your offense going when your head keeps getting snapped back like a Pez dispenser.
Every time he tries to go forward and use his own offense, the jab is stopping him in his tracks. He's doing a great job of fighting behind him.
Just over 3 minutes to go.
Big punch from the clinch. Oh, man, he lands another punch to the head. If you take more of these leg kicks, you will not be able to be very active on your feet.
Good defense to block the strike coming back. A little single collar tie there. Moreno's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling. Oh, he lands another strike to the body, really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection, and these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds. Nice punch there by the assassin baby, Brandon Moreno. Throwing that jab now again, the fighter evades.
You're in a clinch, you can pull down on the head and land these beautiful punches to the head.
Oh, the master of the transition. Nice scramble.
There's no give on that leg kick.
Oh, damaging knee to the head. Stuff's right, so he lands his first takedown.
Oh, now he's in trouble. Oh, nice.
Side control now. Well, you gotta be working off of your back. He's certainly doing so here. Nice punch. Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. All right, he's sort of hanging out here unguarded, DC. Not sure if he's trying to bait him in or what, but not great body language here. Moreno's back to the side control now. All right, good movement by him here on the ground. He really is a master of these transitions.
He is a master of movement on the ground. You never know where he's gonna be.
Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Well, some fighters, when they get cracked in the mouth, they respond well. He got stunned earlier in the round and hasn't really recovered or gotten back into things.
People react differently, right? Some people just get back going. He's having a hard time building his way back into this fight.
Beautiful movement, hip work on the ground here, just outstanding with the transition.
He is not staying in one place on the ground, and that's very important.
Well, he's in a compromising spot here, DC. You gotta figure out a way to get back to your feet. All right, so he's sort of turtled up here, not great body language. Perhaps he's trying to bait him in a little bit. Seconds winding down in round two. All right, close guard now. You gotta be careful. Now he hip escapes. Maybe a triangle opportunity here, DC. Oh, and there's the horn at the end of the round. How about this fight, folks? You see, he was nearly caught in a submission there right at the end of the round. Saved by the bell. So back to the stool. Mentally, probably not in a great place here. We'll see if he can recover and get himself back into this fight. All right, now we take a look back at some of the action in that previous round, DC. A lot to like on both sides, really.
I mean, both were intent on going forward. And what happens when nobody wants to take a step back? They meet in the middle. That's exactly what they did, and they both found success over the course of that round.
Here we go, third round of this championship fight.
Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
Combination lands for him. It was hard to see a miss in that sequence. He's put it all together.
I mean, everything is just flowing. He's like in a zone. It's like the basketball becomes twice the size. This guy today is looking at focus miss in his look.
Moreno's lower jaw very swollen now. Time to bite down on the mouthpiece and move forward.
Nice head kick.
Oh!
In this fight.
And they separate.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Huge strike lands there. Somehow his opponent stayed upright.
I mean, he's still on his feet, but he's not up by much.
Oh, he might be out. Right hook to the head block. Whiffs on that.
Nice takedown land.
Single leg takedown is good. Well, he's up, but oh, is he hurt. Moreno's got the tie clinched. Let's see what he can do.
Ooh, what a punch.
Oh, massive kick. Didn't see that one coming. Oh!
Yeah, he's mixing it all up.
All right, so he's landed some good shots. You hate to be overly critical, but nothing really in terms of combinations tonight.
Well, the jab has been looking great. How about jab, jab, right hand?
Right.
Because eventually you're gonna have to put something on your opponent that's gonna really make him pause. I believe the jab has been working so well, if he drops a big right hand after it, he may be able to finish his fight. Nice punch land.
And a nice job at least staying upright on that. They continue to exchange. Oh, stuffs the takedown without issue.
Big leg kick land.
Well, he felt like he had to kick effectively to win this fight, and he is certainly doing that right now. Nice combination of kicks.
His kickboxing coach is feeling ecstatic right now, watching the guy employ this kick-heavy strategy.
All right, he engages in a single collar tie.
What a fantastic wrestler. Great takedown.
All right, side control now. We'll see if he can advance position. 2 minutes to go in the round. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High level grappling could really be entertaining.
Well, you've got to admire the urgency here. He is trying to keep the judges out of it, light up his opponent left and right. Throws a big right hand, but doesn't find its home.
Nice.
All right, single collar tie now.
Look at him yank the head and land that beautiful punch in the clinch.
And there comes the separation now. Single collar tie now. Connects with a right. The diving punch to the head. Under a minute now to go in this one. Oh, nice work from the bottom. Tags him with the punch. Flush right hand is true. All right, working out of side control here. His opponent trying to control posture, but you got to be careful here. Looks like he's trying for a submission now.
See that very often.
Oh, he's in trouble here. Wow. All right, right into side control. Upper body strength figures to be put to good use here.
Yes, absolutely. And you got to look for his opponent to turn back into him. He should chase guillotine, but the opponent turns to the opposite side. He can take his back, throw his hooks in, try to choke, or flatten him out and just go for the finish.
All right, so that's the end of the round. A lot of highlights from which to choose, but his success in that round certainly rooted in his offensive takedown game.
And that's what he does, right? He's a grinder. He's the type of guy that wants to get a hold of you, drag you to the floor. It doesn't bother him that much if you get back to your feet. He just wants to continue to make you work the entire time because he understands this type of grind most guys can't keep up with.
Punches in bunches, and he hasn't really shown any signs of slowing down here tonight. I'm not sure how much more his opponent can take. Moreno gets stung by that leg kick.
Nice punch here.
Got the single collar tie. Back and forth we go here.
Now the guy's got armbar. He's attacking it on. He's attacking armbar now.
Oh, he picks him up and slams him down.
Big explosive slam. To lift him and slam him out of that armbar, go right into side control. Now let's see what he does, right?
Sometimes when you do that, the choke or the submission can get tighter, but he was able to evade it.
Yes.
Oh, useful strike on the ground that was. Oh, wow, that happened quickly as the fighter reverses position there on the ground.
Unbelievable position change. Wow, what a transition.
Working off of his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. How fun is this to watch as he continues to dole out damage with the ground and pound?
Take it back to the days of guys like Mark Coleman, just beating people. He's gonna attack a triangle choke here. Watch triangle. He needs to push the arm to the side, get his head against the mat. Now watch as he goes to the finish, watch his chest go to the mat. He goes,
and this might just be a matter of time.
Oh, right in the mouth.
All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you gotta be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. Well, the ground and pound is there once again. Strong work here by the assassin baby, Brandon Moreno.
Putting him in exactly the positions he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here. And he understands, being a veteran of so many fights, that as long as he's on top, he's winning. He feels like he's winning here.
Nicely done. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Just over 2 minutes to go. Nice hammer fist. Obvious redness on the right side of his body. Oh, tagged him with that right hand. What a strike that was.
What a strike that he's landing over and over again. His opponent will need to make some adjustments.
Well, you gotta think he's happy with this performance here tonight. Essentially, just the way he drew it up, it's been a striking fight.
It's like a fairy tale. He's doing everything he wanted to do, and his opponent isn't doing much to try and deter him. really messed with the game plan. Now, the guy's attacking the triangle. He finds himself in trouble because he got a little bit lazy in the full guard.
Looks like he's trying to manipulate the head. This could be tight.
Watch triangle, watch triangle.
And he's out.
Right now, it looks like he may be trying to set up an arm triangle choke. He needs to secure the left arm, push it across, and secure it with his head. Watch triangle, watch triangle. Now he's okay. Now he can escape.
Under a minute to go in round four. Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do.
He's gonna start looking to land big shots from the top.
All right, so inside the open guard of his opponent. You gotta be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. Oh, nice job here staying busy off of his back. Nice offense from the bottom. Outstanding ground and pound here. Somewhat of a lost art in MMA, at least in terms of making sure that every strike counts. Not an issue for him.
He's making every single one of them count. He is not pity patting. He's not touching. Every punch that lands, he wants you to feel it.
Moreno's attempting to pass here, but he's denied by the defense. All right, half guard form here, and a lot of offensive options, I would think, at his disposal.
Oh, he's got a ton of options. He has submission options, but I believe the safest option for him here is going to be to use his grounded pound. Build a base, posture up, throw big strikes, get back in position, build posture again, throw big strikes, and just really wear him down with a really secure position in half guard.
All right, so a huge round for him there. That head kick probably would have had me out for good. The guy survives to see another round.
Yeah, but he'll go back to that. It landed so perfectly. He set it up great. He did a great job of mixing up the target early, going up high, and getting the desired result.
Fifth and final round. Moreno gets caught with that punch. Not the easiest guy in the world to hit, but he got caught there. Very nice outside leg kick by him there, DC. We'll see if he follows it up here.
He's really driving his shin into his opponent's thigh, beating his leg up.
Oh, setting up the left hook, but out of range. All right, he'll engage in a single collar tie.
Ooh, head kick lands, he's hurt.
Oh, big knee to the body. How'd he get that one home?
Good stick.
Both guys landing at a pretty decent clip. Oh, a nice punch out of the break there after he had caught the leg. So he is really starting to put it all together now and clearly seems to have found the timing of his opponent. He blocks the shot. Oh, single collar tie here. Oh, look at that head snap back as he connects with another uppercut. Not the first time he's landed that weapon tonight.
That's his best shot, man. He's so good at it. He's so good at finding it. And when you think you got a beat on the right uppercut, he shifts his weight off to the side and lands it on the left side. What a great understanding of landing that punch.
Checks the leg kick. Oh, and he connects with a punch there, DC. You like this guy.
I like this guy a ton. And to watch his punch, I just put a smile on my face.
Takedown defense holds up. Oh, nicely done as he gets the takedown. Under 3 minutes now to go in the fight. All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. Well, you know he's comfortable fighting off of his back.
Now he's chasing the triangle.
And this could be trouble here. Looks like it's pretty tight. He's trying to work his head out of harm's way.
It might be over. Oh! Now he falls back into the finishing position.
Brilliant submission defense there. Ooh, right into side control, DC.
This is where you want to be now because you get to make your opponent decide. If they try to turn back into you, you can attack guillotine. If they turn away to try to get to your knees, you throw your hooks in and you got all your rear choke submissions.
role reversal here, DC.
What a way to switch the position. Fantastic movement by the bottom fighter.
Moreno's has got full mount now. Under 2 minutes remain.
Oh, now trying to isolate an arm, DC.
He needs to move his hips back to cover. He cannot allow him on that angle. He's going to tag armbar here.
Continuing to try to manipulate the head here.
Now he falls back into the finishing position.
Wow. Full guard now, DC.
For the top fighter, you got to be very careful because most submissions come from the full guard. So advance to half. Try to build posture. But if you're the bottom person, the moment your opponent tries to move to the next position, build a shield. Kick off the hips and get back to your feet.
Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's gonna start trying to move to a submission here. It looks like he's trying to attack the arm triangle.
Triangle looks pretty tight, DC. I'm no Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt, but maybe not good here.
No, it looks like it's getting in deep. Watch triangle, watch triangle. There he is. He's moving to the finishing position. Now, watch.
Oh, man, that was slick.
Moreno going to work here from guard. Nice combination there. Everything he throws is with fight-ending intentions. Final 10 seconds of the fight. How about the speed on that reversal there? I mean, I know you can get out of some bad spots, but not with that type of speed.
You cannot allow him to get leverage on the bottom. What a sweep.
All right, so they came in unquestionably the two best in the world in this division, and they showed you exactly why here tonight. A lot of people may think the challenger did enough for me. Slight lean to the champion to retain his title.
I agree with you, John. I thought the champion did just enough to keep his belt. And this has nothing to do with you gotta beat the champ to get the belt. No, the champion outworked him in the big spots and he should retain his title.
The official decision is in, it resides with Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 5 rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. All 3 judges score this contest
49-46.
For the winner by unanimous decision, and still the undisputed UFC flyweight champion of the world, Davison Figueiredo!
Still UFC flyweight champion. He is the best 125-pounder in the world, and tonight there seemed to be a pretty wide margin between number one and number two.
Yeah, but number one, I mean, he is turning these challengers away like flies. He's a great fighter, man. He's hard to deal with. He does everything top-notch, and he retains